Hi guys. If you guys want, you guys can unmute yourselves for right now.
Okay.
How's it going?
Good.
Talon, I haven't had a juice box in so long.
A juice box?
Yeah, are you drinking a juice box?
Yeah.
Are you guys excited to get dancing again?
Yeah.
Yes.
I see a lot of empty couches. Yep. Hi, Bella. Does anyone have Jaden Felkley's number?
Yeah.
She said she's having a hard time getting into Zoom. Somebody help her.
Okay.
Does anyone know the code?
I don't think there is a code for this one.
Oh, actually, I know the code.
There was a link in it.
I think Ella said it.
I had the code a few minutes ago.
Arista, do we need Turners?
Nah, not today.
Okay.
I was going to ask you guys, is that even an option for you if, like, next week we practice pirouettes and stuff?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, do you guys all have a space you can turn on? You're not turning on carpet?
No, I'm not. I won't
be. Well, I mean, you guys can tell me later, too, if you end up being like, I don't know. Hi, Campbell. Hi, Quinn.
Yeah.
We're just waiting for Jaden, and then we'll. I can.
She said that it can't work. I'm over on FaceTime right now, but she said that it's not working. Like the link isn't.
Yeah, the link didn't work for me either. But I just had the code. Now the code's gone.
Yeah, we just typed the code in. I forgot what it is.
I don't create a code, so I'm not sure. I can see if I can.
Oh, 9600175 2.
Wait, Campbell, say that into this, like, say it louder.
Just wait, okay. Just do it in the chat so that.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Wait, where's the chat? Oh, I found it.
Okay, so I'm going to kind of start explaining what we're going to do today. So very first week is kind of intro to get you guys back in the dance groove again and moving your bodies. So we're going to start with a nice warm up and stretch. How many of you guys have stretched at all over break?
I have
a little bit.
Surprise. I thought like two people were raising their hand. But we'll do a nice stretch. Make sure that you guys are really getting deep stretches and not just stretching lightly. And then my plan for today is I really want to work on alignment. So a lot of you guys, well, some of you have been doing high school dance team already, and a lot of you guys are going to be starting next year. And I feel like the biggest thing that I've been noticing in the theme is hips and having a lot of hip trouble. And even if you're not necessarily having like hip pain, there's still some dancers who have a lot of like hip clicking when you're doing certain moves. So goal for today is to give you guys some tools to help with that hip clicking. So I, the more acro training that I've been doing and like more research that I've been doing online, I found that a lot of the, at least clicking parts of it, has to do with lack of muscle surrounding your hips. So sometimes it's just because you got a weak booty. So we're gonna do some like booty exercises that is gonna help support your hips. So, and it's gonna help with your turnout too. What some of you might find is that in certain sides, like when we do some of the knee rotations, some of you guys will have a lot of range of motion on one leg and maybe not on the other leg, and that's okay. It just means that that's the way that your hips are made, and I don't want you to try to push anything, but it's just to help the mobility, and the more you do these exercises, like the more likely you'll create more range of motions too. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'll kind of come back to that. And then we'll see how far we get in that today. I kind of want to try to get through all of that mobility exercise for our alignment. And then if we get through that, then I have some like other across the floor stuff too, and some feet exercises for today. Sound good? Okay. So we are going to warm up our muscles and stretch first. So you guys can stand up.
You want us to mute ourselves?
Doesn't matter. I don't really care. Okay, starting with high knees first.
Oh, because of the background.
Next, we're gonna do power jumps. So you're just gonna plie, you're gonna jump as high as you can. Ready? You're gonna do 10 of them. Go. And stretch. Again, plie.
and stretch. One more time. And notes to me, holding it down. 4, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Yeah.
I could feel it, I could feel it, I could feel it in the air around me. And I could see it, I could see it, I could see it, 'cause it all surrounds me. You got my love out.
Back and forth.
Whoa,
busy thinking about boys.
Grabbing your back leg, keeping your arms up and not your elbows.
I was busy dreaming about boys.
Kind of drop that left hip to the floor.
Head is spinning, thinking about boys. I need that bad boy to do me right on the Friday. And I need that go on to wake me up on the Sunday.
Straighten up both legs.
That one for welcome, come over on Monday night. I want them all. I want them all.
And top of your head to the front of your foot and lay your body on your leg. Holding it down. 4, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Center.
I had to trust the hotel lobby.
Okay, both knees. And stretch. Again, plie. And stretch. Grab your ankles and pull yourself in.
Don't be mad, don't be mad.
Bend your right knee, keeping your left straight.
Boys, I was busy dreaming about boys. Boys.
Switch legs.
Boys, I was busy thinking about boys.
Lock your hands out, so you're in downward dog. Switch legs. Catching both heels on the floor.
Head is spinning, thinking about boys.
And pedaling it out so that your left heel is touching the ground only. And switch. One more time. Switch. Last one. Switch your legs. And sitting down in the saddle.
Don't put me down. I'll never let you sweep me off my feet. I won't let you in again. The messages I've tried to send. My information's just not going in.
Up and up. Focus on your knees, staying up and back. Holding it down, 4, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, splits. Right splits are first. I want everyone facing the side, and I want to be able to see all of you guys. So make sure I can see your splits. I have a question for you guys. When I go this way, is this your right?
Yeah.
That's right to you guys?
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, right splits. We're there in 3, 2, 1. Point your toes. Michaela, try to get your front knee all the way straight. Olivia Klein, stretch your ankle harder. There you go. Sitting up tall right now, share the weight in between both legs. Quinny, try to get that back of your knee onto the floor. So of your front leg, try to get underneath your knee to touch the floor. Okay, arms out if you can. Holding it 4, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Check it out. Sometimes when I'm counting, I start thinking of other things.
And then I always wonder if I miss a number. Okay, left side. We're there in 3, 2, 1. Natalie, engage your toes. Front knees are totally straight. Erica, that left side though. Kylie Fry, that left side. Okay, arms out of Ken. Holding it 4, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good effort, Bella. Okay, middles. We're there in 3, 2, 1. Still point your toes even in your middles, you guys. Brinkley on your elbows. Holding it for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Check it out. Okay. Next up, we are doing our alignment exercises. So for a lot of this, I want you guys to really think about your form and really, really focus on how, not just what you're doing, but how you're doing it and making sure that you're doing it properly. Otherwise, this is going to be no benefit to you. Does that make sense? Yeah. Okay. So for the first one, this one works on your hips' inside range of motion. I feel like as dancers, we always work on turning out. But sometimes that makes the inside of our hips very weak, and that's when we can feel like clicking. I feel like especially if you're a dancer who does like run side leap and you can feel that like left hip click, it's typically because when we run this way, where hips are closed this way, and then we try to get them all the way turned out, and that's when you hear my hip just popped. I don't know if you guys could hear that, but that's when you get that click some of the time. So this works on strengthening the inside range of motion too. So this is like the ugliest squat that you're going to feel like you've ever done in your entire life, but you are going to sit, and I want everyone just to watch really quick. You're going to sit with your butt as low as you can to the ground here. And we're going to drop each knee at a time, and you're going to try to get it to touch the floor. And if you can't touch the floor, that's totally fine. You're going to hold it here for 3 seconds, and we're going to rotate it back, and we're going to do on 4 on each leg. So find some space. Okay, everyone sitting here. Holding it here. Okay, dropping our right knee. Holding it 4, 3, 2, 1, and back. Switch legs. Putting it down. Holding it 4, 3, 2, 1, and back. Switch legs. Holding it 4, 3, 2, 1, and back. Keep that booty really low the whole time. Don't try to switch. I see some people going like this and switching your hips. It's different, okay? So you have to totally keep everything forward and you're just trying to drop your knee, okay? So other leg now. Holding it 4, 3, 2, 1, and back. Almost there, switch legs. Holding it 4, 3, 2, 1, and back. One more time. Pushing it down and holding it 4, 3, 2, 1, and back. Good, and straighten up. Woo! Was that hard for anyone? Like, just raise your hand if that, I don't, Some people? Okay. I'm just curious because, like, as a teacher, I want to know, like, people who I think have tight hips, I want to know if that's a good exercise for people with tight hips or if that's going to help something else. Does that make sense? Okay. Next one we're doing. You guys are going to do some tabletops. So you're going to be laying on your back. This way. The first one we're going to do is we're just going to go halfway up. When you guys do this, I want you to think about squeezing your butt and not squeezing, like, using your back at all, okay? So you're not going to use your back at all. You're going to think about using your butt, and you're going to go up halfway, and we're going to hold it for 4 seconds there. Then we'll go all the way up, hold it for 4 seconds. You'll go down, and then all the way down. Then we're going to do 8 fluid ones. So we'll go all the way up and down, 8, down, all the way, okay, 8 times. Then the last thing we do is 16 pulses. So we'll hold it up, and you're just going to pulse it for 16 times, okay? And the whole time you're thinking about your butt, yes? Get a nice little booty workout, and that's going to help strengthen the muscles around your hip. Got it? All right, I'll turn on music for this one. And what's a good song? I'm always a fan of Hair. Play that one. Hey, on your backs. Ready? Nice and slow. You're lifting up halfway. Holding it for 1, 2, 3, 4. Full. Holding it for 1, 2, 3, 4. Halfway back down. 1, 2, 3, 4. All the way down. 2, 3, 4. 8 all the way up. 8. Down. 7. Down. 6. Down. 5. Down. 4. Down. 3. Down. 2. Down. 1. And down. Hold up in 16 pulses. Everyone get there? Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Bring it down. Okay, so the next thing we do is pretty similar. You guys are gonna go back into your tabletop, but I wanna explain this one just a little bit. So if I was doing a tabletop facing you guys, your knees are never gonna go past parallel, okay? So they're never gonna go in. Does that make sense? Give me a thumbs up if it does. Good. Okay, so knees are never gonna go in. They're always gonna hit this point, but you're gonna work on the side of your hip right now. So it's like you're almost like your butt and the side of your hip right here. So we're gonna be all the way up in our tabletop and you're gonna work on your knees. So we're gonna go halfway out, hold for 4 just like we did, all the way out that you can open your knees with their range, okay? If you can go really far, that's okay. If you can't, that's okay. Then you're gonna close it halfway again, hold it for 4 and close. And it's basically the same thing. Then we do 8 all the way through and then we hold it out as far as we can and do 16 pulses. Make sense? Okay, here we go. On your backs again. All the way up in your tabletop. Pay attention to your knees being parallel. So just try to listen to my voice and watch your knees the whole time. So you're going halfway out. Holding for 1, 2, 3, 4. All the way out. Holding for 1, 2, 3, 4. Halfway in. Holding. 2, 3, 4. Close and parallel. Holding. 2, 3, 4. Opening up each time. Going open. And close, that's 1. Open, and close, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Holding it out, pulsing it out, pulsing it for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Shake it up. Can you guys feel that in the side of your hips?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay, good. Okay, next one. Hold on. I gotta read my notes. Oh, okay, so this is the one where we put our knees together. So we're gonna do our tabletop, and it's gonna be going back to our butt again, but your knees are gonna be all the way in this way. But we're gonna do that with our butt lifting on the half up, 1, 2, 3, 4, up, and same timing. Got it? Okay, here we go. So knees touching this time. And halfway up, we hold 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way up. Hold it, 1, 2, 3, 4, halfway down. 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 8 fluid ones, all the way up and down. We go 1 and down, 2 and down, 3 and down, 4 and down, 5 and down, 6 and down, 7 and down, 8 and down. Holding it up. 16 pulses. We go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Shake it out. Okay. Last little hip exercise that we're gonna do. We're gonna lay on our side. I'm gonna explain it first and then you guys can get set up for it. But we're gonna lay on our side. We'll start with our right leg first. Laying down this way, you guys are going to start with your feet touching together, and then you're gonna switch and lift your foot, and you're gonna try to get your knees to touch together. And then you're gonna switch it back and feet touch, and then you'll try to get your knees to touch again, okay? So this is working on that kind of the beginning thing we did in our squats, still working on range of motion between all the way turning out and all the way turning in, working on that muscle alignment. Does that make sense? Thumbs up if it does.
Are they both?
What was your question?
Are they both bent?
Yep, both bent.
Are they both bent?
Yes. Any other questions? Okay, I'll turn on the song and we can go. So. These ones aren't very difficult at all, but it's just more for, like I said, strengthening the inside and outside. So we're going to do, let's just do 8 slow ones on each leg. I don't want to listen to this though. Okay, here we go. On your sides, feet are touching first. Always pause the room there. 5, 6, 7, we go in. Hold it there. And out. All the way in. And out. In. And out. We go in and out. Three more. And out. Two more. And out. And in. Try to get that foot all the way to the ceiling, touching your knees. Look, look, look. And out. Swing it around to the other side. Ready with your feet touching. Ready, 5, 6, 7, 8, in. And out. And in. Out. And in. Out. In. Lift that foot as high as you can to the ceiling. And out.
toss one. In. And out. Take it up.
Okay. For the last couple minutes of class, we're going to work on our feet a little bit. So we're going to work on strengthening our arches. So that usually means releve. So we're going to do some releves. When you guys releve, really make sure that you're paying attention to your big toe going, or your weight going over your big toe. Does that make sense? Yes? Okay. Yep. So weight goes over your big toe and making sure that you're not rolling your ankles out at all that good stuff. Yes? Highest releve you possibly can. Campbell and Quinn, I like your dog. Okay, here we go. Stand up. All the way up. Hold it. And down. Here we go again. Down, up, down, up, down, quick, now we go up, and down, up, and down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, and go to parallel. So when I'm doing this, I'm trying to keep my ankle bones connected the whole time so that they're never like a sliver of hair. I want your ankle bones to be glued together the whole time that we go up and down. Yes? Okay, here we go, nice and slow. All the way up. And down. Up. Down. And down, up, and down, up, and down, we go up, and down, up, and down, up, and down, up, and down, up, down, up, down, three more,
kidding.
Last one. You got me with me too.
The way you roll that, sticky like okra. Just let me coach ya, show you about my culture. It's a late night show like coach.
Okay, we have time for prances, so we're gonna do some prances across the floor. Working on rolling through our feet. So jumping, rolling. Yes. Let's do. Let me think. Let's do eight of, or I've held it before, but let's do eight of them. Okay, so eight of them across the floor, and then pause, and then turn around. We'll do eight more. Rolling through your feet. Here you go. Five, six, seven, eight. Nice and slow. First thing up. Five, six, seven, and eight. Turn around. Ready? Five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Last one, eight. One more time. Ready? Five, six, seven, eight. We go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, plus one, eight. Bring it in. Okay, you guys can all unmute yourselves.
Hi, Ava.
Hi. Hi. Hi.
Did you guys like the learning those hip exercises? Do you think that will help some of you?
Yeah.
Yes. 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 I'll definitely be doing those hip thrusts.
My hip kept cracking.
Yours like, is?
Like, that's so cute.
So yeah, especially if you're feeling cracking during that, that might be a really good thing, especially if focus on the booty one. That's going to help your hips from cracking too.
Yeah.
Make sense?
Yeah.
Hey, next week we're, well, Rising Stars, I think I see you guys Thursday, right?
I don't know.
Or maybe that's next week. I can't remember. Yeah, that's next week because we're doing more dancing stuff next week. So next week we'll actually like run some dances so you guys can keep those in your brain, because if you didn't know, Brittany's still hoping that we can do a spring show, so I just want to make sure you guys don't totally forget your dances.
Nationals, like, not anymore.
What was that?
Nationals?
Not an option anymore.
It still might be. We don't know yet. Okay. But I think spring show might be before nationals, which is weird. Okay. Like, if it all happens. So, that's kind of the plan. So, next week, we'll start running dances. We'll do a little bit more movement. But other than that, keep working on, like, technique stuff and, like, range of motion so you guys become stronger.
Are we doing, like, stars on those?
What was that?
Are we doing stars or triple S?
I don't know yet either.
What are we doing about small group?
I think for a lot of the routines that we weren't able to totally utilize this year, we might keep for next year. The only hard part about that is I know some of you guys are in, well, actually, I don't know if any of you guys are. I think some of the older groups, they have, like, seniors in it, so that's the only ones I think that need to reevaluate. But, yeah. Okay, hands in. Stars on. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Stars. Hey, okay, bye everyone.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.